In lesson 2.2, you dampen a brown paper towel and hang it up in front of the class and just ask kids what will happen by the end of the class. And most kids will realize that it should dry out, at least somewhat. That way you can begin a discussion of evaporation. You can ask kids, how could I increase the rate of evaporation? And most kids will know that maybe like blowing on it or heating it will probably increase the rate of evaporation. And eventually you want to get to the idea of what's happening on the molecular level and have kids do an experiment to see if heat does increase the rate of evaporation. And the big ideas covered here is that heating increases the motion of molecules, and the faster moving molecules break away from the other ones and evaporate. Also, we take a quick look at water and see that it has positive and negative ends. It's a polar molecule. Another thing that comes out in this lesson is kids help you design a valid experiment. Let's take a look at that. In this activity, you ask kids, how could we design a test to see if heating increases the rate of evaporation? And the way we do it here is you use 2-quart-sized zip-closing plastic bags, and in one you put some hot water, the other you put room temperature water, and you take 2 pieces of brown paper towel and put a drop of water on each one. The students are doing all this, and then place the paper towels at the same time on the hot and room temperature water and watch what happens. The kids will be able to see pretty clearly, pretty quickly, that the water begins to evaporate from the one placed on hot water. You want to have kids understand this on the molecular level. So we have a molecular kind of animation here. The paper towels each have a drop of water on them. One goes on hot water, the other on room temp. And on the hot water, the particles, the water molecules, are moving quickly on the paper towel, and they leave quickly. On the room temperature, they are not moving as fast, so the evaporation doesn't occur at as fast a rate as it does on the hot. Then on the student activity sheet, kids can look at these pictures, relate them to what they saw in the animation and what they saw in their activity, and write captions describing what's going on the molecular level. This is the first time the kids have seen water molecules depicted as traditionally like water molecules. So we include an animation to show the water molecule. Here's the ball and stick model. This is the model called a space filling model. And the idea is that water is made up of 1 oxygen and 2 hydrogens. And we'll eventually show students that we don't want to go into a lot of detail here, but that a water molecule is polar, that it has a positive end and a negative end. And that's why water tends to be attracted to itself. They saw that back in chapter 1, lesson 1, when it was hard to separate water when it was placed on wax paper. And this animation just shows that water's molecules are close together, that the positive and negative parts attract each other. Then if we check out water vapor, because we're talking about evaporation, so water has changed from a liquid to a gas. So we want kids to see that when it becomes a gas, the water molecules themselves don't break apart into like the oxygen and the hydrogen atoms don't come apart, but it's just one water molecule separating from another water molecule. We have students make the classic styrofoam ball model of water with the oxygen and 2 hydrogens, and we eventually mark those with positive and negative areas and use them later as part of an explanation. If you're in an NGSS state, the performance expectation, MSPS 1.4, it's a develop a model that predicts and describes changes in particle motion, temperature, and state of a pure substance when thermal energy is added or removed. Well, in this case, we're adding thermal energy, and the students can see that there is a state change, that evaporation happens faster when water is heated because the particles move faster and break away from the other particles. And if you look closely here, in science and engineering practices, students are developing a model and planning and carrying out an investigation. That's an important part of the lesson. Here, they see the changes of state occur with variations in temperature. That's clear in the lesson. And this idea of a cross-cutting concept, cause and effect, well, if the effect is more rapid evaporation, the cause is that energy was added to the water and the molecules move faster. So, good luck with the lesson, and thanks for watching.